Well, we're seeing temperatures climb into the 70s, but there's still a lot of cloud cover in place, and that's what's keeping us from really reaching the 80s already. We're only at 77 downtown, 72 at the airport, still in the mid-70s along the eastern shore as well. A few places are a little warmer. It's been a little bit drier through the midday in Frederick and even places like Gaithersburg, and you can see those temperatures are climbing for that reason. But overall, it is turning out to be fairly cloudy for most of the region. And the rain showers continue to build along the eastern shore, but notice how they're trying to creep back into Harford County, Cecil County as well. I'd say a lot of this probably isn't reaching the ground, but you may be seeing some light amounts in places like Bel Air and even up towards Perryville. The real focus for the rain right now is along the eastern shore, and we are talking heavy rain here, anywhere from 1 to 3 inches per hour sitting over the same places. Goldsboro, Queen Anne, Centerville, even up towards Chestertown. And so you may be experiencing some concerns on the roads because of the low visibility, and I would have to watch out for some flooding on the roads as well, at least the localized flash flooding as the water starts to pile up in those same areas. Overall, this rain continues to focus along the eastern shore, at least for the next couple of hours. It's also pushing through the southern part of Maryland, now pushing into St. Mary's County. So those places will have to face that as well through the early afternoon. Things are looking okay for Baltimore. The sun may start to break out just for a little bit, and then we'll see another batch of rain move in. You can already see this starting to develop across western Maryland, Garrett County, a couple sprinkles at this point. I know it doesn't look like much, but we should see much more this afternoon because all the moisture continues to come in out of the south, and we have two separate cold fronts that still have to push through, basically squeezing all this moisture right over us, wringing out the atmosphere and bringing more of those heavy downpours. Not to say it's going to rain the entire afternoon. Some people will get some. Some people may not get much at all. But the places that get right under the showers and thunderstorms this afternoon, you're going to have to watch out for the downpours and also watch out for the lightning if you plan to be outside later today. An umbrella would definitely be a good thing to have in mind. Temperatures should only be climbing into the mid-80s in some spots, but I think a lot of places probably won't even get out of the 70s. The forecast for then tonight, we drop down into the upper 60s and the low 70s. The showers really should start to end around 9 o'clock, maybe some linger past then, but at that point, a lot of it is moving into the eastern shore. Baltimore should start to dry out throughout the night. We'll be partly cloudy then tomorrow behind the front. It looks beautiful. Temperatures in the mid-80s with much less humidity. And then that takes us into the weekend where another storm system comes into play. Now, the models are still kind of undecided on this, but it looks like Saturday into Sunday morning looks like the focus for rain. We'll have to let you know if that does change.